So earlier we talked about the Angels, and I have an idea for the Angels, and I wrote a piece about it on Call to the Pen if you guys want to check it out. The Angels are the worst team in the American League, and I think we both picked them to be a wild card team. And earlier this week, I wrote a piece on what I think the Angels should do to, A, just embrace that you need to rebuild, and B, make that rebuild as fast as possible. And the idea is to trade Mike Trout to the Philadelphia Phillies. And I'm going to tell you why I picked Mike Trout. But first, I see your reaction there. What's your initial reaction?
I see where you're going with this, because he's owed a ridiculous amount of money. A team that would be okay to take on that contract would be a team like the Phillies, because he loves Philly. So there has to be some, like...
Yeah, essentially that...
There has to be a good relationship there.
The way this all happened is because about a year ago, I discovered a site called Baseball Trade Values. And recently I started using it again because the trade deadline is coming up and I'm writing pieces about trades and stuff. And it's a pretty accurate site. If you guys want to check it out, it's baseballtradevalues.com. We're not getting paid for this. And it has a 93 or 95% success rate with MLB trades. Like, if you were to type in the Taijuan Walker trade that just happened with the Blue Jays into Baseball Trade Values, it'll probably validate the trade. It'll accept it because the way that they evaluate players is similar to whatever MLB teams does. Whatever. Go look at it yourself, baseballtradevalues.com. Anyway, so the way this happened was, I saw that the Angels had a horrible record. I went on Baseball Trade Values and I looked at what Mike Trout's value is on that site. And I looked at comps. And one of the comps is Aaron Nola. And that's not to say that Mike Trout and Aaron Nola are similar players. They take into account how many years in Mike Trout's career left, what's his money situation. They take all of that into account and they give it a value. Based on all that, him and Aaron Nola have similar values, right? So the Red Sox, here's not the Red Sox, the Angels, my idea is for the Angels and the Phillies to execute a player-for-player trade, Aaron Nola for Mike Trout. The Angels would owe Aaron Nola like $27 million for two more years, and Mike Trout has $377 million left on his contract. So essentially, the Phillies would be saving the Angels would be saving $350 million over the life of Mike Trout's deal.
Ridiculous.
You're getting a 20-year, 8-year-old starter in return. And if that doesn't do it enough for Philly or for the Angels, the Phillies could throw in Alec Baum too. And in this regard, they're going to get an outfielder in return, a guy who is young, a top prospect, and they're getting salary relief.
I thought Baum was a third baseman.
Oh, wait. He's a third baseman? Okay, a third baseman.
Wait. You know what?
I don't know.
Fact check.
But let's make him a DH. Fuck it. He could be a DH. Anyway. What else am I going here? I'm going to have to cut this part because I have a mental block. Okay.
Sorry. I didn't mean to.
Mike Trout has a full no trade clause. So if you go on Baseball Trade Values, they're not going to let you execute that trade because they're assuming Trout's going to say no. Philly is probably the only team in baseball that he would say yes to because he's from Vineland, New Jersey, which is about a half hour away from Philadelphia. He loves the Philadelphia Eagles. He's a Philly fan. You always see him in Philly games and all that shit. So I think that something like this, if the Angels were crazy enough to try it, would work. What do you think?
I want to confirm Alec Baum is listed as a third baseman, not saying he can't play outfield. I think if there's any way, any team that can make it happen, it is the Phillies. It would just be weird to see the Angels do away with the guy they just signed to that massive deal. But I'm looking at the Angels.
But could we look at it similarly to like NBA teams, how NBA teams do sign in trades? Because if you're like Carmelo Anthony, for example, when he was a New York Knicks, the Knicks could offer him a higher contract than any other team because they're the ones that own him in the moment. So it's kind of similar to a sign and trade. Like the Angels are going to gift him with this giant contract that he just got and then say, okay, this season isn't working out. It's turning out that maybe Shohei Ohtani's not going to be able to pitch. His hitting hasn't been that great this season. And he's not owed that much money. So he's not an albatross at the time. Albert Pujols, you still owe him $30 million next year. And he's not getting any younger. You just gave Anthony Rendon $245 million. You're cash strapped. You have no flexibility. Your farm system is one of the worst in the league. Your pitching sucks. So with this move, you're addressing part of your pitching issues because Aaron Nola is a decent pitcher. You're addressing your prospects because you could get someone like Alec Baum. And if you don't want him, you tap into somebody in the Phillies farm system that you like. I'm sure they have somebody else somewhere in there. And you're relieving yourself of almost $40 million a season after 2 years. So that, you know, and then when Pujols' deal expires, you're relieving yourself essentially of $70 million. That, I mean, you could rebuild an entire team with that.
Yeah, I just looked at the farm system. They're like ranked 26th, I think, in Major League Baseball. I already spoke how Joe Adell hasn't really been doing much since he's been called up, strikes out a lot. I think that deal would work, but the Angels would have to pick up some of his contract, like at least $10 million a year or something. Mm. Like that's the only way I can see that work.
Then I don't think the Phillies would do it because I think the only reason the Phillies would do that. Then I don't think the Angels would do it because the only reason why you would want to execute this trade, the only reason why you would want to trade someone like Mike Trout is to dump salary, just like Texas and A-Rod. In 2004, the only reason why Texas wanted to trade A-Rod is because his contract was too big and they didn't have any flexibility to go out and get more players because they were spending all their money on one guy, essentially.
Yeah, but back to the Phillies, they're already paying Bryce Harper for the next 10 years or however, so they're going to take on Trout's contract. Their team isn't ready to win the World Series. Their bullpen sucks. So you would think that they would still want to make moves and add new players. So for them, they can't just get Trout to tie themselves up in money as well, you know?
All right. Well, here we go. Here's where spot rack comes into play. I think the Phillies have, for next year, they're tied to $150 million. Okay. And the salary cap is $210. So at $150, if you get Mike Trout, you're going to be strapped for almost $190 million. But you're trading away Nola, so that number goes down a little bit. Mm-hmm. That gives you about 30 mil to go out and get someone else and stay under the cap. And then the year after that, Pujols is gone. Well, no, that's for the Angels. Anyway, so yeah, you could still go out and get Trevor Bauer next year, or who else is a free agent pitcher? Masahiro Tanaka. I don't know. Someone like that.
Yeah, Girardi loves him.
Yep. I don't know. I'm just trying to be creative, you guys. Don't jump down my throat. What the fuck?
I can see that working. You know what? I didn't think it was like it's always possible that someone like Trout can get traded. I think he's definitely gonna get traded at some point in his career. There's no way the Angels can continue down this path.
Well, and the window is getting smaller and smaller because yes, he's still phenomenal. He's still the greatest player, the best player in baseball, arguably the greatest player that ever lived in baseball. But he's not getting any younger. I mean, how is he 30 yet? I think he's in his
I'm gonna say 29. I'm gonna say he's 28. He's 28. Looking it up. He's 29 today.
Okay.
29, wow. 29 and 21 days. I'm sorry.
Oh, I was what I meant say, is happy that today, birthday, Trout. This was not.
I'm perfect. Saying like as of today, he's 29.
Okay. Okay.
And he's 21 days.
Oh, in 21 days. Got you. Oh, no, he's 29 and 21 days. God. And
August 7th, 1991. So he just turned 29.
And he's played for 10 years, and it's 10 years of greatness, essentially. Again, he's not getting any younger. I'm not saying that he's going to slow down anytime soon, but you would have to think that within the next 5 years or so, 5 or 6 years, he's not going to be the same type of player, in my opinion. I might be wrong. I don't know. Just look at Albert Pujols started declining after year 11. Trout's at year 10 now. So there's a perfect comp right there, in my opinion.
Yeah.
No, you make a good point. So you would accept that trade? Yes or no? Give me a yes or no, man.
Yes.
Okay.
So I'm a Harper fan, and I want Harper to have a better chance of winning a World Series.
If you were the Red Sox, would you trade? How many years does Chris Sale have on his deal?
4.
For Trout. Oh, 4.
Let's see.
I'm trying to make a deal for Trout to the Red Sox to see if that would work. God damn, you guys owe him a lot of money. Woo.
We're screwed.